Welcome to this week's weekly update. This week was Medicaid week, as we looked into what the possible expansion of Medicaid would mean here in Idaho. First, though, we start with a report from State Budget Solutions, a nonpartisan research group that studies fiscal reforms. According to their report, which examined all 50 states, Idaho's single largest portion of debt is its public pension liabilities. Numbers from 2010 were used, as states have not yet released 2011 numbers. The report states that unfunded public pension liabilities in the state accounted for 86.5% of the total debt in the state. 86.5%. State Budget Solutions estimated that Idaho had a little more than $10 billion in unfunded pension liabilities out of the total state debt of $11.6 billion. Percy's executive director, Don Drum, said that due to the state climbing out of the Great Recession, 2010 is a non-representative year. By now, many of you have heard about Governor Butch Otter's task force looking into what an expansion of the Medicaid program would mean for Idaho. Well, according to an Idaho Department of Health and Welfare projection, as a result of Obamacare's health insurance mandate, as many as 12,000 Idahoans could get pushed onto Medicaid, costing taxpayers more than $31 million next year. That's even if the state chooses not to expand the program any further. The projection from the Department of Health and Welfare says that the Medicaid budget is expected to grow by nearly $200 million, around 12%, to $2.15 billion. Tom Shanahan, a spokesman for the department, said that people must either have insurance or pay a fine, and they're assuming people will enroll rather than pay the penalty. Finally this week, the Idaho Freedom Foundation, which produces IdahoReporter.com, released a report analyzing the potential Medicaid expansion and what it means for the state. In the report, policy analyst Parrish Miller argues that focus should be on efficient private sector organizations that provide cost-efficient care solutions and not top-down centralized healthcare planning. Miller, based on cost estimates from Texas, estimates the cost for Idaho over the next 10 years would be between $1 billion and $1.7 billion. Miller also points out an often overlooked part of expanding the Medicaid program, administrative costs. These costs are dealt with entirely by the states, even during the first few years when the medical costs of the expansion would be picked up by the federal government. Miller estimates that, given the administrative costs for the current program in Idaho, the state could see an increase of nearly $30 million more per year in just administrative costs. That wraps up this week's weekly update. Stay in touch with important policy information by visiting our website, liking us on Facebook, or following us on Twitter at Idaho Reporter. Have a great weekend.